Welcome back, folks. I hope you are all having an amazing day. Today I'll be giving a price prediction for Chainlink against Ethereum. Chainlink might fall another 20% to the downside against Ethereum, but afterwards there are signs that Chainlink might go very explosive to the upside. Make sure to watch the entire video to find out what is most likely to happen for Chainlink against Ethereum. Remember, this is not financial advice. Please do your own due diligence before trading. And if you enjoyed the video and found it helpful, please smash the subscribe button and destroy the like button. Without further ado, let's jump straight into the charts. We had broken this significant key zone from around 0.012 Ethereum to 0.0134 Ethereum. Afterwards, we had confirmed it after we had found some support at this key Fibonacci level. Then, after we had confirmed it as resistance, we've moved lower, almost reaching this weird support zone. Then we had bounced back up again to this resistance key zone, and then we had found some support at this Fibonacci retracement level. Then we had broken it and we had fallen to this Fibonacci retracement level. We have been setting several daily candles above this Fibonacci retracement level with several wicks against it. So we have been pushing against this support zone. We might be breaking it eventually and reaching 0.008 for one Chainlink, but we will most likely reach around 0.0076 Ethereum for one Chainlink. That would be some massive support, but this will only occur if we break the current support trend line at around 0.009. The MACD on the daily time frame has given a bearish crossover, so there was significant downwards momentum and we have been pushing against this support already, so we might be breaking it in a couple of days, potentially moving a bit lower and reaching our target. On the weekly time frame, there are few signs of our convergence. We might move a bit lower to our target and then we can potentially start seeing a reversal back up to the upside for Chainlink against Ethereum. But if we break this support trend line at around 0.0076 Ethereum, then we can probably go to 0.0048 Ethereum, because we have not seen a lot of price action within this zone here. So then we would probably fall quickly to this support zone. On the weekly time frame, you can see how we are not really setting in lower lows in the MACD here, and we had actually seen a white candle, so it is a possibility that we start converging and moving upwards. I think we will first reach our target. The change in momentum oscillator on the daily is quite low, but we have seen much lower values for the change in momentum oscillator, so we can go lower and we can even stay lower for a while. So it is definitely an option that we get to our target first before the change in momentum oscillator starts to move back up. On the weekly time frame, you can see how we are finding some significant support here. In the past, we have been supported and bounced off of it several times, and we are currently getting supported by it. If we break this, then I can see us coming back to this value for the change in momentum oscillator, as it is the next support zone, which is at around negative 100 in the change in momentum oscillator. If we reach negative 100 in the change in momentum oscillator, then I can see that as a significant buying opportunity, because in the past, whenever we had seen negative 100 in the change in momentum oscillator on the weekly time frame, we had quickly moved upwards afterwards. For example, on the 11th of June 2018, we had actually moved up around 1200%, 1200% within a couple of months, so it could be seen as a big opportunity. But remember, this is not financial advice. On the daily time frame, you can see how we have been getting rejected by the EMA ribbon ever since we had broken below it. So we are still in a downtrend because we are below it, and we can see this as significant resistance. If we get a bounce to the next resistance Fibonacci retracement level, then that would also be the 13 EMA pushing us down. So there will be significant resistance here, and then we can move further downwards to our target. On the weekly time frame, we are currently below the EMA ribbon. The previous time we were below the EMA ribbon on the weekly time frame, we had gotten a change in momentum oscillator of negative 100. So I think we will probably get a change in momentum oscillator of negative 100. As you can see, we had broken below the EMA ribbon in 2018. On the 18th of June, we had actually seen the bottom for our chaining against Ethereum. And after we had broken through this EMA ribbon to the downside, we had spent around 90 days below the EMA ribbon. But afterwards, we had gone up around 4,000%. So this was the bottom. And afterwards, we had never seen this price again for chaining against Ethereum. So we have never really stayed below the weekly EMA ribbon for a long time. We have currently spent, depending on where you want to take your points, around 190 days for chaining against Ethereum. So anytime soon, I am expecting a reversal for chaining against Ethereum, and then chaining could go explosive to the upside. But in the short term, it is a possibility that we go a bit lower and reach negative 100 in the change in momentum oscillator if we break the support in the change in momentum oscillator. And then I would expect us to start moving upwards quite rapidly. You can see that the stochastic on the weekly time frame is also still a bit bearish. We had formed a bearish crossover, so we can still move a bit lower. On the daily time frame, we are about to form a bullish crossover, so we can see a small bounce back up to the upside to some of the resistance we've been talking about, for example the 13 EMA and this key Fibonacci retracement level at around 0.01 Ethereum. But we can get rejected and move a bit lower to a target of 0.0076 Ethereum for one chaining. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, found it helpful, and that you currently have a better understanding of the situation of the current market. If you found it helpful and you enjoyed it, please smash the subscribe button and destroy the like button, as you don't want to be missing out on future updates. I wish you all an amazing rest of your day, and I hope to see you in the next video.